thank you kids for, they've known a life of being involved in public life. And as we all know, that is not an easy life. And they have stood behind me every step of the way. And not only have they stood behind me, but they have actually led me and encouraged me and fought with me side by side. So Karen, children, thank you so much for your love, for your support. God bless you. Thank you. I want to thank all of you for coming out here today. It is a beautiful day in summer. It's always beautiful in Somerset County, that's right. You must think I'm not from Somerset County if I said that, right? But it is a beautiful day here. It's a Chamber of Commerce day here in Somerset County. And let me just thank everybody here in the local community for the great cooperation and support of and being here and showing up and for, well, for being where it all started. For the Santorum family, and that's why we're here, because our journey, our American journey, started here in Somerset County, and so it is great to be here. Thank you, Somerset County, for coming out for us. You know, the most common question I've had over the past 20 months was, are you running? And the answer I always gave, took me a while, but I came up with this, no, I'm not running, I'm walking. And the reason I was walking is because I wanted to get out and talk to Americans, all across Americans, dozens and dozens of states over the past couple of years, with a heavy sampling on Iowa, New Hampshire, and South Carolina. But I was out talking to people, listening to people, trying to get a sense as to whether what I was feeling inside, the anxiety and the concern I had for the future of our country, was something that was shared. Well, the answer to that was what happened a little over, well, almost 2 years ago now, with the birth of the Tea Party and people standing up and meeting after meeting and holding up their Constitution and talking about those are balloons, not shots. Not that I haven't had my shot shot at me a few times, but people have understood, they understand that something is wrong, that there's something at stake here in America that's important. It's important for us, and it's important for the future of our country. Now, what is it? Is it the economy? Sure, it's the economy. Who can say it's not the economy when you're looking at this pathetic rate of growth and the incredibly, just discouragingly high rate of unemployment. Not 9.1%, but 14-15% of people who really want to get work and they can't find work. And you can look at this administration and see, oh, what did they do in response? They just sent money to state capitals and municipalities to keep their government workers on the payroll and forgot about the rest of America out here trying to survive and try to grow. Is it gas prices? Yeah, sure it's gas prices. We're from here in Somerset County, mineral-rich Somerset County. And we have coal and gas and all sorts of resources here. And we have a president who doesn't want us to access those resources and then complains that prices of energy are high. And if you look at the record of spending under this president, he came in, sure he came in with a problem. And then in that hole he was in, he kept digging and digging and digging. Now for every dollar we spend, thanks to this president, 40 cents is borrowed. 40 cents is going to be put on every man, woman, and child to pay the interest on for the rest of their lives. Who are we? Who are you, Mr. President? Who are you, Mr. President, to say that you and your administration should take 40 cents out of every dollar and borrow it from future generations to prop you up? He's done worse than that. He's devalued our currency by pumping Fed Reserve currency, pumping money, inflating our commodities, our food prices, our oil prices. which is a horrible penalty on working Americans, on saving Americans. He's devalued our currency, and he's not just devalued our currency, he's devalued our culture. Through our marriage and through not standing up for the Defense of Marriage Act. For federal funding of abortions. He's devaluing our dollars, and he devalues our other currency, our moral currency. All of this is bad enough, but I think Americans now realize there's even more. There's something more that is concerning America. And that's why I'm here in Somerset County. I'm here in Somerset County because my grandfather came to this county way back in 1927. Did he come here because the government was promising him all sorts of benefits, promising him all sorts of handouts and bailouts? No. No, he left the country where the government made all the promises. He left the country and I would add a good job. He had a job on a mail train after World War I, which he fought in. He had that job on a mail train. He lived in a beautiful little idyllic town in the mountains, right down on a lake. I visited it. It is truly gorgeous. And I said, why would anyone want to leave eight brothers and sisters, live a stable job in a beautiful place at the foot of the Dolomite Mountains? One word, one reason. Freedom. Freedom. He was watching what Mussolini was doing. He was watching what he was inculcating into his oldest son. And he said, I will not stand for this. And so he left. And he came here. Took a way late trip to Detroit, but he eventually came here. And he started in the coal mines here in Conemaugh Township in northern Somerset County in Carpenters Park, Pennsylvania. And he worked, and he worked to give his children, my dad, who was 7 years old when he came in 1930, the opportunity for freedom, to live your dreams. Because he knew that America believed in him, believed in people, gave people a shot. If they worked hard, they could succeed. That's the America that my grandfather came to. That's the America that my dad lived in. And that's the America that we need again today. That is what is unique. The President of the United States, just a few weeks ago, in responding to Paul Ryan's budget, said this, and he was talking about Medicare, Medicaid, and unemployment insurance. And he said, the country is a better country with those programs. I'll go one step further, he said. America was not a great country until those programs. Ladies and gentlemen, America was a great country before 1965. America was a great country before government decided that it had to start taking from those. Oh. Sorry, we have someone who's, I think the heat has got to them. So make sure if there's any emergency personnel that can get here, I want to make sure that this person gets some help. Here you go. Hand that down. There you go.
You okay? Just tell us he's okay.
Right here.
Obviously, something has happened here in the middle of Senator Rick Santorum's speech, in which somebody may have fainted, apparently. They got a chair and some water, and the former U.S. senator doing the right thing